John Prosser is a great big phony.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got him.
I will give you $10 if you subscribe right now. That's actually not true.
I lied.
But subscribe anyway and turn on all notifications so you don't miss the next episode. Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to Front Page Tech, FBT, FUPUTA, the show that gives you all the latest tech news from one geek that is me to another that is you. It's Tuesday, it's bar. Listen, I figured if you've seen Front Page Tech a bunch of times, I don't need to say the usual stuff. I could just make noises and you get it. New episode of Genius Bar is available right now on all your favorite podcast apps. Link down in the description to make it easy because I know you're lazy. And oh man, lots of drama, juicy bits in today's show. So now let's talk tech news. Good news. All right, so first up for the day, story numero uno. You know, this is Front Page Tech. It's a Tuesday. Actually, that part doesn't matter. It is a day, period. And you know what that means? iPhone 13 news. Yay. And we're putting that at the beginning of the show, so you know something juicy's coming at the end. So we got a couple new significant reports that have come out for iPhone 13. One from DigiTimes saying that the upcoming iPhone 13 Pro models will use an LTPO display, enabling high refresh rates up to 125 hertz. Holy shit, that's pretty crazy, huh? I mean, we heard that it might have 120 hertz, but 125 hertz? Whoa. New major breaking news. This show has a budget of like $0, so we don't have money for the real sound effects. Actually, just kidding. That's not real. It's not 125 hertz. I made that up. It's 120 hertz, of course. Actually, nothing new here, so you're welcome. And yes, while this isn't technically new information, it's definitely not your first time hearing that the iPhone 13 will have a 120 hertz display panel. That's not new. But this report from DigiTimes is new, and the fact that it's from DigiTimes, and it corroborates, it says the same thing other things said. It's one of those things where hearing the same thing that you've been hearing, but from a different outlet, solidifies the other things that you've been hearing over time about the same thing. Oh, by the way, that's not all. Display analyst Ross Young, who has an incredible track record in terms of display panels on devices, he says that Apple's adoption of LTPO tech will make LTPO the dominant display technology over the next 2 years within the US. So goodbye LTPS displays and hello LTPO. Now, I would like to say that that leak in particular is kind of odd because, just as Apple adopting 5G finally made 5G quote unquote real, Apple adopting LTPO will finally make that quote unquote real. Because yes, other companies have been releasing devices with LTPO panels in them, and yes, other companies have been releasing devices with 5G, but because of the sheer volume of product that Apple ships out every year, anything that they adopt will almost instantly become the most popular form of that technology. And that's not me being a fanboy, that's just how it is. Dems is the facts, as they say. Does anyone actually say that? I say that. If you watch this show, then you already know I love WeVPN. And right now, it's their birthday!
Happy birthday, WeVPN!
It has officially been a full year since the guys at WeVPN left their day jobs over at those other VPN companies to instead create one of their own that they truly believe in. A super fast, super safe, and secure VPN that actually puts its users first. And right now, to celebrate their birthday, they're offering you the lowest prices they ever have. They're like, happy birthday to us. Sure, we'll take less money. Get a 2-year plan at 73% off with 2 months free for just $2.69 a month. 69. Even better, if you're watching Front Page Tech right now, you can get an additional 10% off just by going to wevpn.com/FPT. WeVPN allows you to be protected and secure online, lets you unlock content from all of your favorite streaming services, and unlike the other guys, they don't keep any of your logs, so not even they know what you're doing. Out of a sea of VPNs all over the place, WeVPN is the only one that I truly believe in. So to get started today, or to make the switch, link down in the description below, wevpn.com/FPT, extra 10% off. All right, so next up, did any of you buy a HomePod? And don't you lie to me, because I don't think you did. At least, not enough of you. Well, if one of the reasons that you never purchased a HomePod was because they didn't have a screen, then prepare your butt, because Apple's going to put a screen in it. I mean that Apple's going to put a screen in the HomePod, not in your butt. What? All right, so I could just redo this take. But, like, I'm not gonna. The new Bloomberg report mentions a couple different new products. One, an Apple TV with HomePod speaker that has a camera for video calls while you're using your TV because, just because, I guess. It also mentions a new futuristic high-end HomePod speaker that would include an iPad connected to a robotic arm that tracks and follows users around the room. What? I mean, to give you the best idea of this, these concepts right here seem to give us a pretty good look at what it might look like. This sounds like something that would not be coming soon. Definitely something that, if it actually ends up seeing the light of day ever, would happen a while from now. So if you're one of those people who usually doesn't buy certain products because you're anticipating a new Apple product based on a leak, do not do that with this. Because who knows how long you'd end up waiting around for this. And life is short, man. There are so many people right now, so many of you watching this show right now, listening to my words, and you know it's true. You're sitting there, you're gonna feel guilty after this listening to me. You're sitting there, and you know that you want a product. Like, there's a product right now that you know you could buy, and it would make you happy. But instead, you're sitting on your sweaty ass waiting for this next product based on leaks that you think might come true, and you think you might want this product. So instead of buying the product that would make your heart happy right now, you're waiting around for the one that you think might make you happy. And there's so many things that could happen between right now and a product that could make you happy right now, and later on, however long, when that product you think you want finally comes out. You never know. You could be hit by a train tomorrow, and then all of a sudden you'd be like, oh man, I really should have bought that Echo Show with the screen that I really wanted. That would have been cool too. Well, too bad, because now your legs are all f***ed up and you're near death. Okay, well, you know, glad we covered that. Glad we did that. That made a lot of sense. You're welcome, I think. All right, last up, final thing of the day. Oh man, oh man, oh man, oh man. The drama, the salt. John Prosser puts out a leak. Journalists hop in their little rowboats and roll through a sea of salt. So if you missed the last episode of Fuppata, I gave you your first look at the Google Pixel Watch. I had received a bunch of real images of the watch from a very trusted source, but the source asked me not to share those images publicly, so instead, I gave them to a render artist and had him recreate it so we could show you. Well, as that episode was going live, I had received information from a different source who's familiar with all sorts of different phone releases from Google, Samsung, pretty much everyone. They reached out to me and let me know that they were informed that the Pixel 5a, codenamed Barbet, was canceled due to the ongoing chip shortage. In fact, this wasn't like just a text like, hey man, I think this is happening. This was like, I saw the paperwork from Google that said the thing. So of course, I wait a little bit and then I tweet the information along with saying that the Pixel 4a and 4a 5G will continue to be sold in its place, and that gets the internet buzzing. I mean, it makes sense, right? The mid-range Pixel devices are really important phones to some people across the world. So this information wasn't exactly good news to them. And soon after my tweet, Android Central put out their own article saying that they have confirmed my information with two of their other independent sources. Okay, so that's it and that's all. Sad news is bad news. Oh well, that's the end of the story, right? Wrong. Google themselves steps in about an hour or so later and puts out a comment of their own saying, Pixel 5a 5G is not canceled. It will be available later this year in the US and Japan. And oh man, did the media have a field day with this one?
John Prosser was wrong.
Google debunks prolifically.
Jen Pierce is a great big phony.
Hey, everybody. This guy's a great big phony!
John Prosser again with a swing and a miss.
How embarrassing!
Well, I wouldn't call this a swing and a miss, per se. I would call this more of like a foul ball.
Because regardless of the disingenuous news titles, no. Google didn't just shit all over my report, they more so clarified it.
Yes, the Pixel 5a has been canceled for every major market other than the US and Japan. I mean, I can see how and where my source got this information mixed up, but at the end of the day, a lot of major markets that love and adore mid-range phones will not be getting this one. Google also confirmed the chip shortage issue that I cited. But no, the Pixel 5a is technically not canceled. That part is not accurate, and that's on me.
But it will only be coming to the US and Japan.
So with basically every other major market not getting this device, I can see how my source, when they're told that it's canceled, that they assumed that that meant everywhere. Either way, I'm not like embarrassed by this leak or this report. I mean, was the information 100% correct? No. But because I reported it, it was obviously close enough that Google themselves had to respond, and now the people that were waiting or expecting this phone or really care about it know that unless you live in the United States or Japan, you will not be able to buy it. You would not have known that otherwise.
But yes, John Prosser swings and misses again. I am an embarrassment and I should be burned at the stake. Thank you for coming.
Also, I don't have any more eyebrows to shave off, so, like, what do you want me to do?